Oh, yes. Okay, nice to see you once again. I hope you're enjoying yourself in the Lord. I hope everything is okay with you. Okay, so I want to talk to Nigerian youths, especially. I want to give my advice to Nigerian youths this time around. I want to talk to all of you. I would like if you can pay attention to hear this word that I want to say. I will not take much of your time, but I think if you listen to this word, it will do you good. I want to tell you a story in the Bible, what happened in the Bible. I'm talking about the case of Esau and Jacob. Esau and Jacob. I'm talking to all of you, especially Nigerian youths, for the coming election. What I want you to understand. Maybe you did not know this before, but I want you to understand this. The senior brother is Esau. They are the father and the mother, you know. They are the same, from the same father and same mother in the Bible, according to the word of God, Esau and Jacob. So many of you know about it. Esau is the senior brother, Jacob is the junior brother. But something happened. One day, Esau came home, was hungry, and the brother prepared yam porridge. Prepare yam porridge. He said, "Oh, my brother, I'm hungry. Please give me food to eat." The brother said, "Okay, you're hungry." He said, "Yes." He said, "Okay. I will give you this food to eat, but I need something from you. Can you give me the position, the birthright? I need to take number one position. Can you give it to me? Can you give me the future?" No, it means give me the future. He said, "Just give me the food. Give me the food. Let me eat. Take the future. Take the birthright. Take the, like to be number one. Take number one. I don't care." Brother gave him the food he ate and said, take the future, take the birthright. According to the law, the firstborn son is the one that will inherit, will take the leadership or be number one or be in power or be in control after their father, after the father, when their father is no more there. The firstborn son, according to the law, the Jewish law, according to the tradition, is supposed to be the next one in power. But this young man said to his brother, to Jacob, "You can take the future, take the position, give me the food to eat." The brother gave him food, offered him the food, he ate the food. This is the thing, just go like that. He think it is. He think everything is finished. It is not finished. A day came when their father became old, want to die. He asked the firstborn son, the firstborn Esau, to go and cook food for him, so that he can be able to transfer the mantle of leadership upon him, to transfer the blessing upon him. The first son Esau went to the bush, went out to go and hunt for animal, to for him to get animal and prepare food for the father, so that can transfer the authority, the blessing, the greatness upon him. On the way, he forgot one thing. Let me tell you something. Your word is you. I want to tell you the three things that is carrying a heavy authority in your life: your word, your signature, your hand, your signature, and your blood. Your blood, your word, your signature, your blood is your life. And these three things is the symbol of authority, is the symbol of power that you are carrying. So he went to go and search for the meat in the bush, in the forest. The mother called the second son, Jacob, and said, because already this young man have transferred the authority to the junior brother. The day the junior brother offered him yam porridge, and he said, take that position, take that future. It means take that future. Take that future that is coming. I want you to understand that there is nothing you will eat today that will cause you not to be hungry tomorrow. Pick it for me. Just pick it. There is no amount of food or drink that you eat today that will stop you from being hungry tomorrow. And tomorrow, today was tomorrow yesterday. Today was tomorrow yesterday. So the future remains the key. You must always focus on tomorrow. Focus on the unseen, because the unseen is the one that brings everything you need. The mother called him up, and the whole thing, what he said that day, I give it to you. Exchange was taken in the realm of spirit. Exchange have happened. And this is how the blessing was transferred to the junior brother, to Jacob. And when he came back, he cried. No way. The father said, there is no more blessing. Blessing is no more there for you. Because he himself is the one that used his mouth and transferred to his brother the day he ate the yam porridge. Listen very carefully. You, that the evil politician will offer money for you to vote for them. You, that they will offer food for you to vote for them. You, that they will offer drinks for you to vote for them. You are selling your future. This is the secret that they are using against you to be taking that future, so that you will be without destiny. You will be without future. If you want your future to be bright, so many of you have eaten it to your mouth. So many of you have signed it with your hand. Your PVC, if you take money and cast your vote to any demonic man and they offer you food or drink or money, you have given them your future. This is your authority. Use your hand and cast it. I said to you, it's a symbol of authority. Your hand, your mouth, and your blood. You have released it to them. Say, take the future. Just give me that one bottle of beer, or even if they give you 1 million naira, 1 million naira can never buy your future. Once you sell your future, you have sold it. Once you sell it, you have sold it. That 1 million naira will vanish away, and you will be without destiny, you will be without greatness, you will be without future. And a life without future is a life, it is a meaningless life, a life without meaning. You're supposed to don't look forward to be a president, to be a senator, to be a governor or president. You're supposed to say, I refuse to give my vote, my authority, my future to any demonic man that offer me money, or offer me beer, or offer me food. If they offer you this, what they are trying to tell you is just the same thing Jacob told his brother. Can you give me the future? Can you give me the greatness and take today? Can you give me tomorrow and take today? And the tomorrow is gone. There will be no end of tomorrow. Tomorrow keep coming. There will be no end of tomorrow. So my advice to you is, if you take money from any politician to give your vote, you are Esau. If you take drink from them, or take food from them, or take anything, or take they gave you rice, bag of rice, tomatoes, and all this stuff for you to share and cast your vote to them. All of you that did it is Esau. You are without destiny. You are giving your destiny to occultic people. They seize your future. You are without a future. You are without a destiny. Your pastors collect money from them. That's why they are not they are without future. They can't speak, they can't talk to them when they are doing evil, because the same spirit is transferred to them. They are together. The occultic spirit is in them. So they cannot fight them when they enter into power and they begin to exercise their evil. There's no way for your pastor to speak, because your pastor is also Esau. He have also eaten his future, his destiny, through the money that they offered him. We can stop this. We can stop this corruption. We can stop this by saying no to any politician that offer you anything for you to give your authority, for you to give your PBC, for you to put your signature, because casting your vote, putting your hand, is a symbol of authority. It's a symbol of your power. It's a symbol that you are giving your future to them. And you must give your future to somebody who will take care of your future and make your future to be brighter and brighter and beautiful and glorious. I am telling you this, if you cast your vote to any man this time around and take anything from the person to cast your vote, you are already cursed. I decree you are cursed already. You are cursed for doing that. If you take anything from any politician this time to give your vote, you are cursed already. Yeah, I'm not going to say it. It is the reality of life. Don't say this man is cursing. I'm not cursing. This is not the very truth. I'm telling you what you don't know before. So I am advising you to vote for AAC. Vote for AAC. Forget. I am not forcing you. For me, my vote, I won't give my vote to PDP or APC. My vote, I'm giving it to AAC. Take it back. This is where my vote is going. I am giving my vote to AAC, Mr. Sowore. Mr. Sowore is the one I advise you. If you ask me to advise you, I would advise you to give your vote to AAC. Simple. Go ahead and vote for any man you want, or anyone you want, but don't take anything from them. Don't take any dime. Don't take anything from them. If you do that, you are cursed. You have damaged your future. You have damaged your tomorrow. You have damaged your destiny. And remember, Esau cried. The father said, nothing is left. No leftover. The blessing is gone, and it is gone. I pray that you, this time around, that you will understand that Jacob is a wise guy, he's a smart guy, he's a sharp guy, and he understands that today was tomorrow yesterday. And he understands that the future holds everything. Your destiny is very important. So many of you is having a great destiny. Don't sell your destiny to the wicked and occultic people. I want you to hear this. Forward it to the whole people. Forward this to as many youths that you can, so that they will know what they've been doing before, that the enemy is using to capture them, to seize their future, to cast them to darkness. So if they understand this and know that their life, their tomorrow is in their hand, they should not give their authority to a wrong person. Your mouth, your word, your hand, your blood, your PVC, symbol of authority. Be careful, be wise to give it to a right, to give your future to somebody that will carry it like egg, that will take care of it, that will cause your tomorrow to deliver the difficult things, to bring it to you. God bless you, Nigerian people. God bless you, Nigerian youths. God bless you, the whole people of Nigeria, as we make a wise decision.